Then on table one, I open ace eight suited under the gun. Now, I'm going to get 3-bet by Wild Ghost again. And this time he makes the biggest size 3-bet to 12x, whereas before he made smaller 3-bet sizes on our smaller opens. And basically, I think this is a fold. So I think a lot of players at these stakes are thinking, this guy is just running me over and I have to 4-bet him at some point. Some players might call out position thinking that's the adjustment to make. In this spot, I definitely don't think that's the case. So the thought process might be, well, I should have 4-bet the last hand, or I should 4-bet this hand, and I have an under-the-gun range that I can represent, and he's 3-bet me for the third consecutive time, so I'm definitely going to 4-bet here. I think that's a mistake. I think that he's very unlikely to be light here, for one, because he's going to know that he's 3-bet us twice in a row. And to 3-bet us the third time, he's either going to be on the level that this player is going to get frustrated and flip out, and it's a good thing I have queens, or he's going to be on the level that, you know, he's never going to expect me to 3-bet as a bluff three times in a row, especially the third time versus his under the gun open. Now, if he has the latter thought process and has the ace five of spades here, then my hat's off to him. That's a great play. But when we think about our own adjustments, our adjustment shouldn't be to fight back against this 3-bet. Our adjustment should have been to fold preflop. Because we have a player on our left 3-betting us a lot, we need to narrow our opening ranges from every spot. And that's the correct adjustment to make when you're getting 3-bet a lot by the player on your direct left, is to have a tighter opening range and to fight back with that tighter opening range more often, as opposed to opening wider and having to give up a lot. So I've already failed to make the correct adjustment in this spot with my ace eight of hearts. The time to make the correct adjustment has passed, because that would be to press the fold button preflop, and I didn't do that. So now I have to cut my losses by folding to the 3-bet. And so I think a lot of players would get confused, because they wouldn't look all the way back to the start of the hand to see where they didn't make the proper adjustment. They would look at this exact moment in time when they get 3-bet and decide that they have to adjust from there, where the time for adjustments already passed. So if he was on the level that he was bluffing and that this was a good bluff spot because he thinks I'm a disciplined player, then hats off to him, that's a great play. If he was on the level that I have jacks or tens or an extended value range, ace queen or queens, and this guy's just going to flip out against me, then that's also a great play by him. Either way, what I should be doing is I should be determining not to spew in this spot now that I've already made the mistake of opening preflop. Now on table 3, we 5x'd a button limp with jacks in the small blind, and we got called by Ruddy86, who's a reg who I have a lot of recent history with, so I've been playing a lot with this week. And I see bet Queen-8-6 dry with jacks, which is pretty standard. We could check call, but I think versus a reg, betting is better. When the 6 pairs on the turn, I'm going to be a lot more prone to double barrel here with a hand like ace-jack of spades than two jacks, and that's simply a function of my equity versus a queen x calling hand. So when we do check and he bets large on dry, I'm gonna make a pretty clear fold. I'm not too happy about it, but at the same time, I don't expect him to be calling 5x cold, then floating dry to bet large. I would expect him to only bet this large on dry with a made hand or a total air bluff. So I think he's in his value range more often than not. I don't have a good hand with equity versus his value range to fight back if I thought that he was light here a lot, because his calling range versus a double barrel or versus a turn check raise is going to be hands that have jacks in jail. Now on table 1, I call the loose opener in blind versus blind with king 4 of diamonds, and this guy's opening over 70% of his small blinds, so I think this is a really clear call with king 4 of diamonds. I think our hand is too good to 3-bet, and when we flop ace-jack-7 with 1 diamond and backdoor Broadway, I think he's going to c-bet this board with his 70% range misses 100% of the time. So my decision here really is between calling and raising. Folding's not an option given how wide his range and frequencies to bet are here. And raising is just going to be a lot better because we do have the flexibility that a diamond turn or a diamond 10 or a queen offers us. And we expect him to just be folding an inordinately large amount of the time, whereas our ability to bluff catch in position with king high is pretty limited.